All right, this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com. We're on another field trip. I'm here in Petaluma, California, on basically Petaluma Boulevard, North and East Washington. And we're gonna visit today the seed bank. So actually, if you can see the building, it's a nice old historic building, Sonoma County National Bank. And it was available for rent. And this seed company, rareseeds.com, rented it. And now they have a location here in California. They're located back east. Or Midwest, actually, and they have a great full-color catalog I did mention on a previous episode. So let's go ahead and cross the street and go in there and check it out. All right, we're at 199 Petaluma Boulevard North, just about to go into Baker Creek Seed Company. It's their retail location here in Petaluma, California. I'd highly recommend to, you know, get one of their catalogs or go on to their website before you actually visit the store. If you do live in the area, it's definitely worth a trip, even if you're coming from San Francisco. It's a nice 1 hour drive up here to Petaluma, and it's a beautiful place to visit and check out. I mean, you could spend hours here in the seed store looking through all the seeds. So I recommend getting their catalog. They have a free catalog, or actually going to their website and reading through the descriptions and selecting the seeds that you want to buy and have a list, and then come in to the store and just literally pick out what you want and maybe do a little bit more browsing. It's gonna be a lot easier that way. Otherwise, you're gonna find you're sitting here and walking through the whole store and there's so many seeds, you could really easily get overwhelmed. They have over 1,400 varieties. So let's come in and check out what they got. All right, so since I was here last time when they just opened up, they've filled out a lot. They've got a lot more locally produced products, and as well as their seeds and, you know, garden tools and books and all kinds of accessories and things to help you grow more food. So this is one of the things I really like. They have a locally produced product, and these are raw olives. So these are cured actually without any heat, and they look really delicious to me. The I won't mention any prices on the air, but these look really delicious. So they have you know, things like in the background here, books to help you learn about, you know, growing food and growing things. As well as, check this out, they have you know, some samples of heirloom carrots over here. So, you know, carrots just don't come in the standard orange color. They come in colors like yellow and purple and red, all kinds of different colors. So, you know, grow some heirloom carrots. Here's some heirloom tomatoes. And we're gonna go over and check out the tomato section next. So now we're in the tomato section here at Baker Creek Seeds Company in Petaluma, California. They have over 200 varieties of tomatoes, many of them being heirloom tomatoes. So, you know, most people have seen the common, you know, kind of yellow tomatoes, but have you ever seen a white tomato? And they have some amazing pictures on some of their seed packets. So these are literally white tomatoes. It's an heirloom variety. It's amazing. They have so many different kinds of tomatoes. And as I said in, you know, previous videos, I like to grow the cherry type tomatoes. They seem to be more prolific, produce more per plant, and have a continual harvest. Whereas if you grow, you know, something like this, a nice huge tomato, you know, maybe you have a couple, you know, tomatoes, a bunch on the plant, but then they take a while to ripen up. And, you know, hey, I need to eat every day, and you're waiting for your tomatoes to ripen. Whereas the cherries will ripen up and keep going and keep ripening all season long. All right. So how many of you have had iceberg lettuce and thought that's the only kind of lettuce? Well, here at Baker Creek Seeds, they have over 30 varieties of different kinds of lettuces. So from Asian lettuce to Boston lettuce to deer tongue lettuce to Lola Rosa to Mascara, all different kinds of lettuce. And you know, each different variety will grow in certain climate conditions. So some may be like this one is slow to bolt. Some are heading types, some are leafing types. I tend to grow more of the leafing types where I could pick off the leaves and do a continual harvest rather than some of the Bostons and some of the, you know, head lettuces. And this is, I guess, the berries, gourds, and grains, and greens section. So they have all different kinds of things here. And this is an up-and-coming, virtually unknown in the United States, except if you're a turkey farmer. The reason why I say that is turkey farmers will plant these to attract turkeys to the land so then they could hunt them, basically. But the chufa is actually basically an edible root crop, and it's originally in Spain, it was used to make horchata. And so this is like a little root crop, and it reminds me of, it has like a nice nutty flavor. And so you could grow this, it's like a sedge type plant, kind of a grassy type plant, and it'll reproduce these tubers, and the tubers are what we want to eat. They have a nice nutty type flavor with virtually no flat fat in them, so it's another nice edible tuber you could eat with the chufas. All right, so now we're in the pepper section. They have over 70 different varieties of peppers, from sweet peppers to hot peppers and all kinds of peppers in between. It's so amazing. I mean, you probably never knew there was, you know, and this is only here, there's 70 varieties that you could buy. So some, you know, are really hot. Here's a really interesting variety. Look at that. It looks like a UFO, a pepper that looks like a UFO. Maybe it's from outer space. But yeah, so I prefer the sweet pepper varieties, and I prefer the smaller type peppers, you know, so they have some, I don't know if I see them here, but there's some smaller peppers that actually are more prolific. You know, I've found the larger pepper plants maybe will produce only a couple peppers for the whole season, whereas the smaller pepper plants will produce a lot more. I think they're called mini bells. So the red mini bells, yellow mini bells, and orange mini bells are my favorite currently to grow. So they have 35 different varieties of cucumber plants here at Baker Creek Seed Company. Some of my favorites, let's see, I love the lemon cucumbers. I don't know if I see them here. Let's see, this is actually my favorite. This is related to the cucumber. This West Indy Burr Gherkin actually was the predecessor of all conventional cucumbers. This is the wild counterpart, actually. So they can actually get bitter on you if you don't pick them really quickly. Here's my favorite, the lemon cucumber. They're nice round cucumbers. And here's a cucumber I'm buying today, actually called Dragon's Egg. So it looks like a dragon's egg, looks like an egg, and then it's white instead of the yellow. So they have, you know, things like white cucumbers and, you know, yellow cucumbers and all different kinds of cucumbers. Here's an interesting looking cucumber. It almost looks like a melon. After all, you know, cucumbers are related to the melons. All right, so this is the carrot section here, and they have 17 different varieties of carrots, from, you know, standard orange small carrots to, you know, white carrots and lunar white carrots and yellow carrots and purple carrots and red carrots and all different kinds of carrots and all different other varieties. So, you know, most people have only had the standard orange carrot, but, you know, carrots come in a lot of different colors, and it's really important to, you know, try and grow all these different varieties to keep the gene pool, or, you know, the seeds going of those strains, because, you know, a lot of varieties have gone extinct. All right, so Baker Creek Seeds here are supporting the local community by having an art show from a local school. So kids' artwork, they're showing kids' artwork and different things. And they also have, you know, many different local products, you know. So these are some locally made herbal botanicals that you could buy and bring home. So they have every different section, they have different local products that you could buy. Some, you know, bees products and different things like that, and herb products and things like that. Besides selling seeds, they sell other things that'll help you garden, like these cool chicken wire hats. You could, you know, garden when you're in these hats, and, you know, it's going to protect you from that. Just kidding. Okay, so these are actually called gopher baskets. So my friend Don had actually gophers, and, you know, it basically, the gophers would go under the ground and literally eat the roots of the plant. You just see the plants keel over, and he had tomato plants, and actually last year he didn't have too many tomatoes because he didn't use these things, and these are gopher baskets. So if you grow in raised beds, definitely getting some kind of this chicken wire. Actually, I'd get something a little bit thicker, actually, to lay on the bottom of the raised bed so gophers can't come up and eat your roots. But, you know, this you could use on a per plant basis. So you'd actually put the root ball and plant it in here, and then it'd grow up, and then the thing is, you know, the gophers can't really chew through the metal. So very useful to have. All right, so I just saw a movie Up in the Air, and they had basically a elite card throwdown or showdown. So we're gonna do a seed showdown or throwdown, and I'm gonna tell you what I got and why. So let's see, the first one, got red Malabar spinach. The reason for that is it's a great summer vegetable to grow, loves the heat, grows in tropical places. It'll grow year round in places like Florida. Boom, next one I got cilantro, or Vietnamese coriander. I try to expand my varieties of foods that I eat, and the cilantro is really a rare variety. They don't see too much out of the tropics. Tastes just like cilantro. Boom, oh, that one fell down. All right, next one, we have some on the backside. Melon Petite Gris de Rennes. That's definitely a melon that's gonna grow, a 2-pound melon that is, you know, more adapted to, you know, maybe colder weather. So hopefully we're gonna try that this year, see how well it does. Throw down the next one, toothache plant. I love the toothache plant, gives a nice sensation, tingling sensation even in your mouth. after you grow it. Okay, next throwdown. Golden midget watermelons. These watermelons actually, you know, ripen up and they have an orange rind, and you'll see them when they ripen up and they're nice and small, so hopefully we'll get some good yields this year. Boom, West Indian burr gherkins. These are my favorite cucumbers, bar none. They're a little spiny and they're really related more to like a wild, you could consider them like a wild type cucumber. Boom, dragon's egg cucumber. You know, it's gonna be a white, small, lemon style cucumber, and it's supposed to have an amazing taste. And the last thing I'm getting today, boom, strawberry spinach. So that will create abundance of edible leaves, much like lamb's quarters, and also little red berries that are, you know, I don't know if they're like super tasty or sweet, but they're definitely good. All right, so this is John Kohler with growingyourgreens.com here at Baker Creek Seed Company here in Petaluma, California. And if you don't live in the area, you could visit their website and order all these seeds online, rareseeds.com. We'll see you next time.